So how do we convert then from decimal number like we just did? So let's actually do the same one. What did I do first? What did I do last? 139. So 139 in base 10 is equal to what in base 16? Let's convert it to hexadecimal. Maybe not surprisingly, it's going to be the exact same process. We're going to say take 139. How many times does 16 go into 139? And here we might actually need to do some maths. So 139 divided by 16 will go in 8 times. So 8 with a remainder of what? Well, it's going to be a remainder of, so let me subtract 8 and multiply that by 16 to get the decimal portion with a remainder of 11. Now in decimal in hexadecimal, an 11 is a what? Well, an 11 in this case is a B. Okay? So that first math is kind of a maybe more of a pain. But once we have that, then it goes pretty quick. 16 goes into 8 how many times? 0 with a remainder of what? 16, which is a what? Well, we don't have a 16, so that can't be right. What did I do wrong? Oh, with a remainder of 8, duh. Okay. 0 times with a remainder of 8, not 16. I was really messed up for there for a second. Okay, so an 8b is what that is. Now let's convert this 8b into a binary number to test something. What's an 8? Well, an 8 is going to be a 0, 1, whoops. Ah. Erase that. All right, an 8 is going to be a 1, 0, 0, 0, and a b is going to be a 1, 0, 1, 1. Now, I don't have the ability to pull that old video back up, but you do it. Go to the last video and see if this is equivalent to this, and it ought to be. This ought to be the number we got, and it looks like it from the previous video. So we go through that same process. Okay? Or I suppose we could do the same thing over here, although it'd probably get more complicated because, yeah, I wouldn't do it this way. Okay, so how many 16s can I get into? Well, first of all, if I go one more, 256, then that's too many. And so I don't want to do that. How many 16s can I get into 139? Well, as it turns out, we've just found out the answer is 8. And then 8 times 16 will get us to that 11 short of 139. And then we have the 11 coming in for that second number. This process doesn't work as well here. This process works better when we're trying to convert to hexadecimal most of the time, unless it's a really easy number. Like if I get a number like 34, well, if I get a number like 34, I can easily say that there are two 16s and two 2s. And so that might be quicker that way. So I always glance at the number just to see what it is and see if I can maybe do it in my head and then go from there. But that's how we convert from hexadecimal to decimal. Let's, or sorry, other way around, decimal to hexadecimal. Let's try one more just for fun. So let's take a number like 2000. I'm trying to think of an easy number. And 98. Nope, base 10 to base 16. Okay, so how many times does, I did not pick an easy number, but we'll go with it. 16, whoa. How many times does 16 go into 2098? So, pull up the old calculator. 2098. Oh, I'm remembering why I thought this would be easy. It's easier than I'm thinking it is. And 16 is going to go in 131 times with a remainder of 0.125 of 16. So if I subtract 131 to get that remainder and then multiply that by 16, because that's the portion of the number it is, that's a remainder of 2. Okay. So then we say, how many times does 16 go into 131? So 131 divided by 16 is 8 times. Okay, with a remainder of what? Again, we'll have to figure out what the remainder is. So I'll subtract 8, multiply that by 16. And the remainder is 3. And then I say, how many times does 16 go into 8? The answer is going to be 0 with a remainder of 8. So 8, 3, 2 is the answer. And again, keep in mind, if we get a person with 10 fingers counting apples and we get a person with 16 fingers counting apples, the person with 10 is going to come up with 2098. The person with 16 is going to come up with 832. And by the way, the person with 2 fingers is going to come up with, if we just do that conversion, if I can operate this thing correctly, we're going to get an 8 and a 3 and a 2. And that is equivalent. All three of those things are equivalent if we start counting. It's just counting by different numbers. Okay? Whew. You feeling good? Okay, that's been a lot. But hopefully that's all making sense. Now we get into a couple of other trickier things. Not trickier, they just other exciting things, supplemental things. There's other things we need to do in order to kind of round out this idea of numbering systems. So we'll continue on with that in the next video. Spencer out.